I couldn't work out why I was so tired all the time, but I was just trying to do everyday things and just trying, powering through, thinking I was just being weak. And it was then that she told me about the spoons theory. It was a girl with lupus originally, but it applies to any chronic illness. And she'd gone out for a coffee with one of her friends, which was a rarity for her. And a friend said, "You're no fun anymore." And she said, "What do you mean?" She says, "Well, every time I ring you up and ask you to come out," she says, you always have to say you can't come. And she looked around the room and she gathered up all the spoons and she handed to them. She says, "Right." She says, "Every time we're going to go through an ordinary day," she says, "and every time you do something that's going to use a unit of energy, put a spoon on the table." So she says, "Right, you wake up on the morning and you've got to work yourself up." So she put a spoon down. You go have a shower, she put another spoon down. You come back and get dressed. She says, some of these would take two or three. And she went through an ordinary day and then she said to her, "Right, you get home and your friend rings and said, do you want to come out for a drink?" And her friend looked, she says, "Well, I've got no spoons left." She said, "No, exactly." She says, "I need to know how much energy I can expend in an ordinary day, and then I've got to manage it. And sometimes I just can't do things because there are things that you can't not do." And she says, "I've got to, yes, you can save some, you can bank some from a few days, but not a great deal. And if you know you've got something coming, you try and bank as much as you can and then dip into the next couple of days, but you know you're going to be flattened by it." So I went home and started my own spoons diary, so I knew roughly what my outgoings were and then just tailored my day to it, and it just makes such a difference. You don't feel so useless.